Now let me show you a magic. The moment I click on this button, it creates 8 different pivot tables for me in just 2 or 3 seconds. In this video, we're gonna create a magic. Yes, that's right. What we're gonna do is we're gonna insert multiple pivot tables, let's say 5 or maybe 10, with a single click. Yes, that's right, in a single click. So make sure to watch this video till the end, and do not forget to download a free ebook at the end of this video where we have 100 VBA codes, ready to use VBA codes for you. And now let's get started. So this is the data that I have, and this is the code that I have written to create a pivot table. So this is a code to create a single pivot table. And when I click on run button, it gives me a new pivot table by inserting a new worksheet. And now let me delete this worksheet and show you how this code works in steps. So we have a new worksheet, and the name of the worksheet is changed. And now I have a blank pivot table. And again, the next rows field, the name of the salespersons. And then columns field. And here I have my value. And in the end, it will change the formatting of the pivot table. All right, so first of all, I have these variables in my code. And each of these variables has a specific purpose. The first variable defines the worksheet where we're going to add our pivot table. And the second one represents the worksheet where we have the source data. And then the third one is the pivot cache. And the fourth one is itself the pivot table. And the fifth one, P range, is the range where we have the source data. And last two variables helps us to store the last row and last column that we use to define the range of the source data. Now, in the second part of the code, we have these 5 lines. Now, from these 5 lines, the first one and the last one helps you to deal with the error. So the first one allows this code to run even if an error occurs. And these 2 lines, the second and fourth one, disables the display alerts, and then it enables the display alert. And in between, the third line deletes if there is any worksheet in the workbook with the name of pivot table. In this part, we insert a new worksheet with the name pivot table and before the sheet. So first of all, it specifies, hey, we need to add a new sheet before the active sheet. And then it inserts a new sheet with the name pivot table. And with these 2 lines, it defines the pivot table to the variable P sheet and the sales data worksheet, which is the source data, to variable D sheet. Now in the code, whenever you need to specify or refer to the pivot table worksheet, you need to use P sheet, and for the source data sheet, you need to use D sheet. Now, this part of the code defines the source data from the source worksheet. So the first line, let's say you have this worksheet and you have data here. The first line will start from the A1 and goes to the last row. And the second line will go to the left side of the data and go to the last column. And using these 2 points, last column and last row, the third line will identify the last cell of the data, last filled cell in the data. And that is how it defines the entire source data range. Now what happens is when you create a pivot table, Excel, before inserting a pivot table, creates a pivot cache. And this line of code, this particular line of code, does exactly the same. It creates a pivot cache, and then this line of code inserts a blank pivot table. So it will create a cache, and this will create a blank pivot table. Once you have a blank pivot table, the next thing is to add row fields and column fields. And this is what this part of the code does. It adds region first, and then it adds salesperson. Even though you can see here, I have position numbers, 1 for region and 2 for salesperson. And I also have this orientation defined here, that is Excel row field. That means I want to add this particular field in the row. And after that, we have this part of the code to add a column field. So we are using product as a column. So if we have salesperson, the region, and salesperson here, this part of the code, this particular part of the code, add products here. Now, this is the main part of this code that adds data to the values. So we are using this column total sales where we have the values. And when we have row fields and then we have column fields, this part of the code add values to the pivot table. And I'm using the column name. This is the orientation. And I'm also using this calculation Excel sum. That means I want sum of the values. And then I'm defining the format and also a name for the values column. And in the end, we have these two lines which applies a particular formatting to the pivot table. The first one actually adds a stripe of different, you know, one line with a color and one line without a color. So it's like a alternate stripes. And the second line applies a specific style to the pivot table. So there are a list of styles that you can use. And this is the code for a particular pivot table style. And in the end, we have this word and sub to end the code. That's it. So here I have this button here. And when I click on this button, you can see it creates 8 different pivot tables in just a few seconds. Now, again, I'm using the same VBA code to create multiple pivot tables. And let me open my Visual Basic Editor and show you how this code actually works. So first of all, I have the code, which is exactly same like we have used while creating a single pivot table. Now, in this code, instead of creating a single pivot table, we are creating 8 different pivot tables. And this part of the code is exactly same like we have in the single pivot table code. But what difference we have in this code is we have 8 different sections within the code to create 8 different pivot tables. Now, mind you, here there's one thing that you need to understand. When I'm creating 8 different pivot tables, here in this section of the code, I'm defining a pivot cache first. So this pivot cache has been used for every pivot table that I'm creating. So if I'm creating 8 pivot tables and using this, I'm referring to this pivot cache 8 times. You can see here, P cache, and here I'm using P cache. So this is one of the most important thing that you need to take care while creating multiple pivot tables from same source data. You need to use same pivot cache for all the pivot tables, because if you're creating multiple pivot cache, it will increase the size of your workbook. So let me take you through to the code. So this is the first pivot table where I'm defining the pivot cache, and then again I'm defining the pivot table field, and then the value field total sales, and then again the next pivot table pivot cache, the rows field, and then the values field. And in the same way, I have 10 different pivot tables to create. And in the end, I'm using a loop, this loop that apply a set of formatting to each pivot table in the worksheet. So once the worksheet has been created, and then I'm creating 8 different pivot tables, and then this loop goes to each pivot table and apply the formatting that I have defined here. And you can see here I have these two lines, which I have also used in the single pivot table code.
Hey, thanks for watching this video, and you can download your free ebook that I have promised from the link in the description. And make sure to subscribe to the channel, because I'll be coming out with a lot of cool Excel tips and tricks in coming weeks. So make sure to subscribe and like this video.